To correctly use textures from Substance Painter in Unreal Engine, there's a few things we have to be aware of. First up in Substance Painter, File, Export Textures. This will make a little pop-up appear where you can change a few things. First up, make sure this output directory is going somewhere you know. Underneath that, you have Output Template. We want to use Unreal Engine Packed. This is the most efficient way to export our textures as it packs our metallic and roughness maps together. You'll see the maps that is exported out in the console here. Moving over to Unreal Engine now, we want to import our model and our textures. Select Import in the content browser here and find your model first. This will be the OBJ or FBX that you use to texture in Substance Painter. The default import settings here should be fine. Just make sure this material import method says create new materials. If you've got an object made of lots of little objects, in advance you can find combine meshes. Just make it a little bit simpler. Select import and you should see your model now in your content browser. Next up, we want to import all our texture files that we just exported out of Substance Painter. These should come in pretty easily. You can do this all at once, and I'd recommend making a folder system if you're working with lots and lots of different materials. In your Unreal project, you should now have your model, a material, and then all the texture maps. To get it to look like Substance Painter, we're going to have to add all the texture maps to our material that got imported with the model. Double-click on the material in your content browser, and you'll be able to start editing it. You may have slightly different maps than I do here. These are the most common ones you'll have. Base color, emissive, normal, and then a mixed map of ambient occlusion, roughness, and metallic. We want to double-click on this one and look for sRGB on the right. We want to turn that off. This is so Unreal can recognize this as a linear color texture. As you can see here, it's actually three maps hidden in each of the color channels. Red is ambient occlusion, green is roughness, and blue is metallic. Returning to the material now, we're going to drag and drop all the textures into the material graph here. Make it easy for yourself and try to make this look as neat as possible. From here, it's just about connecting up our textures to our material node. This is pretty self-explanatory as it's usually just name to name. So base color goes into the base color. With the mixed map, just remember that it's split up. So the green channel goes into the roughness and the blue channel goes in metallic. You can usually ignore the ambient occlusion map. You can plug it in, but a lot of the time you're not going to use it anyway. Save the material and then return to your viewport, and you should see now that your material has updated. It should look pretty similar to your Substance Painter file now. If anything does look wrong, it's most likely changing that linear color on the roughness metallic map or plugging things into the wrong area. As a bonus, let's see how we can make a parameter here to control the intensity of our emissive. Make a bit of space for yourself and add a multiply node. You can right click to search, or multiply it, you can also just hold M and left click on the screen. Connect the RGB to the A and the output to the emissive color. In the B slot, we're going to add a scalar parameter. Hold S and left click on the screen for this one. This parameter is going to control how bright our emissive gets, so call it something like emissive intensity. Connect this up to the B slot in our multiply node, and then head over to left to change some of these settings. Make the default value 1, slider minimum 1, and then slider max something like 100. With this connected, we want to save our material, and this will give us a little slider hidden in our material parameters that we can increase to make our emissive a lot brighter. Since this is a parameter, we can do this in real time. So if you pull out your material graph so you can see your viewport as well, then just make sure you find this parameter section and you'll be able to increase it and see the results instantly. Your material should now look exactly like it does in Substance Painter, and you'll just have to repeat this process for any other models and materials that you want to put in your Unreal scene.